So Trello have been quite aggressive recently, introducing a brand new feature called the Dashcard Power-Up. We're going to overview what it is, how it works, and how Trello are trying to build their team back up in terms of helping project management become more view-based. So we'll dive into that in today's video. If you're new here, please do hit subscribe. We will love to have you as a subscriber. We run over plenty of productivity software. So Trello have introduced a brand new tool inside of their experience. It's sort of like a view inside of your existing experience like boards. And Trello have been a great example of a team that's developing quite fast because they're seeing what other experiences are inside of ClickUp and Monday, and they're trying to compete with it, which is a fantastic way to keep up with the market, especially as they've been pretty stale with their Kanban experience for a while, but more recently adding plenty of views that make a lot of sense to the experience. And this brand new Dashcards power up is a great example of that, and actually looks and works pretty functionally inside of Trello. So basically, imagine Trello Dashcards as a preview of whatever filter you want to set up. And they act as a card, but they are basically like a dashboard. So for example, if you wanted to be able to track the progress of, for example, what's due in one of your columns, then you can. And whenever that card is moved over, it will update in real time to reflect that, which is really cool. So for example, you can have that for a wide variety of uses. You could have your company's Q2 revenue being appeared and be able to modify it in real time. So you can create custom dashboards and change that into, for example, tables and much more. But it reflects information that you and your team might want to see at a glance. And it has a wide variety of filters so you can build your own. A great example of this is, for example, team workload, and being able to see what exactly you and your team have on their plate. So if you're a manager, you could say, okay, how much is this person working on? And what's coming up in terms of how can I unblock them with their bottlenecks? Now, Trello say this is fairly easy to add. You can actually add this power up through the directory onto your board from the link that I'll put in the description below, and you can build them out fairly easily. Now, they're saying as well, you can choose from 8 dashcard templates to create your own, but I can be assured that you can go much further in terms of how you can use it. And it's even an ability to sift through high level amounts of data. So this really plays into the metrics, history, and alerts that they aim to really build on in the future. So that's great for more advanced users of Trello. However, for the basic users, it's got some great filtering drop-down abilities that I think will come into play for the future. I'll include a link to this all in case I wasn't able to explain it. It's actually quite a hard topic to explain because it's quite broad in terms of how it can do, what it can do with data, but it's a really great leap forward for Trello. Thank you so much for stopping by today. If you'd like to subscribe, please do find us in the link in the description. And if you fancy checking out more videos, there will be more there too. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.